we're all going to the concert.
Yeah, what's the concert?
Megadeth and Scorpions.
Oh. Yeah. Gates open in 30 minutes. What's her? Yeah, we're inside Budweiser Stadium. Stage. Whatever.
So you want, no, yeah. So you want double XL though? Yeah, 212s and 111.
Okay, we're inside Molson Amphitheater. Actually, Budweiser Stage. They changed the name of the place. So, show starts in 30 minutes.
Yeah.
And we just bought some merchandise and we got ripped off.
So, I'm gonna. Rob shows up and goes, "Mom, is that enough?"
Hey, guys!
I didn't know you were gonna do the hey, guys! Alright, so, sorry that's a little dark, but we're in the car. The show just finished, the Megadeth Scorpions concert just finished. I'm not going to show you guys the merchandise, we're going to post it on our social media, but we bought two shirts each. I bought a Scorpions Megadeth t-shirt, he bought a Scorpions Megadeth t-shirt. We paid $200 for four t-shirts. It's insane. That's more than we pay for the tickets. To give those in Europe an idea, $200 Canadian is like 150 euros. Like 150 euros, 150 US dollars, something around that line. For four t-shirts, it's insane. Yesterday at Secret Reich, I paid $25 half per t-shirt. But anyways, enough of me ranting about how much these freaking t-shirts, it's insane what the price of these t-shirts is. Just want to give you guys a quick review of the concert. So first I want to ask him, what did you think of Megadeth?
Megadeth was amazing. I loved Megadeth. They had so much intensity. And everyone, almost everyone that went there came for them.
Yeah, I would say there was a lot of people there for Megadeth. I mean, there was a lot of people there for Scorpions too, but there was a lot of people there for Megadeth. They were really good. I hadn't seen Megadeth since 1994 live, so this was a treat. It was a short set, I think 10 songs. They started with Hangar 18, they finished with Holy Wars, and in the middle, they sprinkled Peace Cells, Tornado of Souls, Symphony of Destruction, A Tout Le Monde. I mean, it was like almost the greatest hits. Maybe there's two songs that they didn't play that you would consider part of their greatest hits. The Conjuring and... let me think. I know I can't think of what's the other song that I would put it in there. In My Darkest Hour. So those two probably were the only two that I would say to make their greatest hits was missing. But Sweating Bullets, they did Sweating Bullets. I mean, the set was short. It was about 10 songs. But it was non-stop. It was like go, 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 go.
Yeah.
Right? Like they didn't like take any break. The song would finish, boom,
song,
it was just start another one right away. The other thing I will say is that I always say that the Megadeth from 1994 was their greatest lineup ever with Nick Menza and Marty Friedman on the guitar. Having said that, this new lineup that they have, it was really good. The drummer is really good. The guitar player is really good. It was good. Like it was really good. It was really nice to see Megadeth. I hadn't seen Megadeth since 1994, so I was really excited to see them, and they were good. I really enjoyed it. I really enjoyed it. Short set, but very good. Scorpions, your first time, I mean, it was your first time watching Megadeth live, but first time seeing Scorpions, what did you think?
Scorpions is not Megadeth. Like, I don't know why they were kind of touring together, because they're both different, like, really different, right? But then I like Scorpions because there was like three or four songs that I actually knew from Scorpions that I didn't know came from Scorpions.
Yeah, like Big City Nights,
mm-hmm.
Wind of Change, rock you like a hurricane. Yeah, I mean, I saw scorpions, I think about, has to be about 20 years ago, I saw scorpions with Whitesnake. They were touring together at that time, and they had Dokken as well. I saw them about 20 years ago. And I didn't like them live when I saw them 20 years ago because the instruments were louder than Klaus's voice. He's so short, by the way. Like, you almost put him in your pocket. So tiny. So when I saw them like about 20 years ago, the instruments were louder than his voice. So it was basically the whole concert was instrumental because you couldn't hear him singing. And that kind of ruined it for me. I really didn't enjoy it. This one, the sound quality was mint. The guitars, the drums, his voice, everything was perfectly aligned. You could hear him sing. And you know what? For a guy his age, the guy can still hit the notes. Holy crap, he has amazing voice. Klaus. I love that name, Klaus.
It's the name of the fish on American Dad. Klaus.
I love, you know, he's so tiny with his hat and stuff. Like, you know, he's like your grandfather kind of thing. You know what I mean? Like, he's a grandfather figure. His voice was amazing. Didn't you think his voice was amazing?
It was absolutely amazing. I don't know how he hits those high notes.
No, like, I mean, for a guy his age, he can still hit the high notes. But the whole band, the other thing I really digged about the Scorpions set, two things I really dig. When they played Still Loving You, that was the first song I've ever heard from Scorpions. I was a teenager when that song came out. And when they played Still Loving You, I had goosebumps. I mean, it was absolutely beautiful. The guitar playing on that song, the solo, the rhythm of the guitar, oh my God, absolutely amazing. So that to me was one of the highlights. The second highlight was they gave a shout out to Lemmy.
They did.
Right, they give a shout out to Lemmy because their new drummer used to be Motorhead's drummer. So they gave Lemmy a shout out and they did a cover song of Motorhead. They did Overkill. So they did a Motorhead cover, Overkill, followed by the drummer did a huge drum solo, like for a good 5 minute drum solo. So that was really cool for them to give a shout out to Lemmy. They had Lemmy on this big screen behind the stage. And they did Overkill from Motorhead. So I thought that was really nice. The fact that they have Motorhead's drummer with them. Well, he was also the drummer for King Diamond and Halloween and stuff. Other bands. But he was the drummer for Motorhead from 1992 until now. Until Lemmy passed away. So he was Motorhead's drummer for a long time. So the fact that they integrated him into the band. And then the fact that he's in the band. They decide to do a cover song, Overkill. It was a good cover song too. It's not a long song. I was kind of hoping for Ace of Spades, to be honest with you. If you're gonna do a cover song of Motorhead, like Eat the Rich, Ace of Spades, Orgasmatron.
Any Triple H song.
Orgasmatron would be a good one. Sepultura does an amazing cover of Orgasmatron. So, yeah, but they did Overkill. And it was amazing. It was really good. It was really good. So, you know, it was really good. People are waving.
Yeah.
So, anyways, that was it for me. I really enjoyed the show. I really enjoyed both bands. It was really good. Mm-hmm. You know, Scorpions is rock and roll, ballads and stuff, slower than Megadeth. But it was really nice for me. It was really nice to see Megadeth. Like I said, I hadn't seen them since 1994. And I hadn't seen Scorpions for 20 years. So, it was really nice to see both bands. And I can mark those off my checklist again. One thing I'll say for sure. If Megadeth came again as the headliners, I would go. Because, you know what? They were good. They were really good. Yeah. Scorpions was good, but Megadeth was really good. All right, guys. This is it for us. Don't forget to check our new video tomorrow. Because you know what tomorrow is? Tomorrow is Winter Sun
Day.
Yes. And with Winter Sun Day comes happiness to our faces. So, tomorrow, don't forget to check Winter Sun Day. Mm-hmm. All right, take care, guys.
See you guys.